Heavenly Father, thank you for being our great, great Father. Thank you for loving us so much even before I love you. Thank you for having this worship even though we are not still available to meet person to person at church. Lord, today is the first Sunday of September. As we are all new starter this month, we want to be new children of God. Lord, please keep us the mind which is always heading to you during the worship. Please help us open our eyes, our ears, and our heart to listen and learn from your word. And please guide us to always do our best in every situation and to love one another. Thank you again. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of everlasting. Amen.
Restored exceeding joy. Your grace times we were so afraid. So many years we had lost our way, but we would hold on to your promise. Your mighty hand would deliver us, a guiding light through the wilderness, and we would hold on to your promise. You said, I am the rock that you stand.
안녕하세요. 체이스의 김효섭 선교사입니다. 그동안 평안하셨는지요? 이곳 체이스도 이제 날씨가 많이 따뜻해져서 눈이 녹고 또 한 해 농사 사역 준비로 분주히 움직이고 있습니다. 작년에는 저희 여름 단기 선교를 받지 못해서 여러 가지 좀 어려움이 있었지만은 농사 사역과 또 가축 사역 또 하나님께서 또 지혜 주셔서 그 인터넷으로 복음 전하고 또 사람들과 교제하는 일들 그렇게 큰 문제가 없었습니다. 다만 이쪽 그 원주민들 중에서 코로나로 인해서 돌아가신 분들이 몇 분 계셔서 조금 분위기가 안 좋았는데 지금 백신을 맞고 사람들이 조금 분위기가 좀 나아지고 있고요. 이곳은 지금 저희가 이제 소를 키우려고 축사를 짓고 또 해를 준비하고 감사하게도 작년에 우리 그 농기계를 조금 그 어태치먼트를 구할 수 있어서 헤이 농사를 한 3에이크를 줬습니다. 그래서 같이 지금 함께 농사 사역을 같이 지금 돕고 있는 우리 원주민 밥하고 일을 진행했고요. 또 저 뒤편에 보시면은 저희 밭이 있는데 아직 정리가 좀 안 됐지만 곧 이제 정리가 될 줄로 생각이 됩니다. 올해도 상황이 어떻게 될지 모르겠지만 여러 가지 우리 과선 사역과 또 농업 선교 또 우리 네스카니스의 체포를 제거하는 그런 일들로 지금 이제 분주하게 지금 움직이고 있고요. 진행되는 여러 가지 사역을 자주 이렇게 소식을 못 전해드려서 죄송합니다. 이제 진행되는 2021년도의 사역을 좀 더 구체적인 내용들을 가지고 인사드리고 좀 나누도록 하겠습니다. 감사를 드리고 또 여러 가지 어려운 상황 가운데서 늘 기도해 주시고 협력해 주셔서 너무나도 감사를 드립니다. 그리고 늘 강건하시고 주님의 은혜 가운데서 늘 승리하시는 모든 성도님들 될 수 있도록 저희도 여기서 기도하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
Today's message is taken from Joshua 1:1-9, and the title of today's message is I Will Never Leave You, Joshua 1:1-9. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people, get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I am about to give them to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country to the Mediterranean Sea in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be courageous, be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous? Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen. Amen. Amen, my lovelies. So today we're in the book of Joshua. What a wonderful, wonderful book. Is Joshua found in the New Testament or the Old Testament, y'all? Yep, you got it. In the Old. And it comes right after the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy ends with whose death? Any guesses? Begins with a mo and ends with a sis. Yep, you got it. Moses' death. Moses had died, and the people mourned and cried over the death of their leader for 30 days. How long had Moses been the Israelites' leader? You got it. For at least 40 years. First, Moses led them out of Egypt and then led them in the wilderness. He was their leader in the wilderness, telling the people what God wanted from them and guiding them to do the things that God wanted them to do. The book of Deuteronomy says that there was no other prophet like Moses, no other prophet like Moses that God used to show all his power and awesome deeds. Moses was the only prophet that God knew face to face. Imagine to be the only one that God knew face to face. Cool, huh? Moses was a great, great leader. But now he was dead. The people had come all the way to the edge of the promised land after their 40-year journey, and Moses couldn't be there to lead them into it. But was God like, too bad, so sad. Maybe in the next 40 years, guys. Peace. I'm sorry about that. Nope. A new leader had been made to lead the people into the promised land. And what was his name, y'all? Yep, you got it. It was Joshua. The Bible says that Joshua was filled with the spirit of wisdom because Moses obeyed God when God told him to lay his hands on Joshua and give him some of his power to lead the people. And that's why and how the people followed Joshua. So, my lovelies, Joshua 1 starts off with the Lord speaking to Joshua, telling Joshua, Moses is gone. And now you, Joshua, you and the people must get ready to cross the Jordan River into the promised land, the land that I promised the Israelites. My man Joshua, just like I promised Moses, I will give you every piece of land that your foot sets on, that your feet are on. God tells Joshua, for the rest of your life, no one will be able to stand against you, just because, just like Moses, I will be with you. This is what God promises Joshua. He promises to be with Joshua just like he was with Moses. My lovelies, does our God ever break his promises? Nope. Like, look at what we've just read. Even without Moses, God led his people into the land that he promised them. Our God is a God of promises. And I believe that this is his greatest promise to us, that he is with us and that he will never, never, never leave us. My lovelies, what are you afraid of? Nothing? I feel like y'all are afraid of nothing. I feel like I can hear you say that you guys are afraid of nothing. Well, y'all are brave. I'm afraid of so many things. I'm afraid of a lot of things. But there's one thing that I'm afraid of the most. Can you guess it? No, it's not spiders. But guys, this doesn't mean that I like spiders. Please don't bring your pet spiders to church the next time you come. I mean, I'm okay with it, but I feel like the other pastors may be a little afraid. Okay, so for them, let's not bring our pet spiders to church. Okay, so moving on. No spiders. I'm afraid of the people that love me the most leaving me. I hate goodbyes. But as I read this verse, I thought to myself, guys, who loves us the most? Who do you think loves you the most? Your parents? Your brother? Your sister? Your aunts? Your uncles? Your grandparents? Yep, you're right. They all love you. But their love for you is incomparable to God's love for you. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that they love you less or that they love you little. No, we all know that that's not true. My point is that God loves you so much, so much. And this God that loves us so much promises to never leave us. Never. Nothing can separate us from God's love. Not death, not angels, not demons, not people, nothing. Because he is a God that has promised to never leave us, just like he promised Moses, just like he promised Joshua. But there's something we have to do. We have to be strong and courageous. Now, does that mean we shouldn't be afraid of things? No, not at all. In fact, if we're just doing things that don't scare us, then we're not being courageous at all. We're just doing the things that we always do. But if we're scared of something and we still do it, that's when we're being courageous. God wants us to be strong and courageous because that's when we put our trust in him, and that's when we fully obey him. Remember when God met Moses at the burning bush and he told him to go rescue his people, the Israelites? Was Moses like, okay? No, in the beginning, Moses was like, God, no, thank you. I'm a nobody. What would I even say to the people? What would I say to Pharaoh? What if they don't believe me? Moses was even like, God, I'm sorry, but could you like send someone else? Moses was scared. I mean, he had to go back to the place that he ran away from. He had to tell the person he grew up with, Pharaoh, to let God's people go. Awkward. I mean, imagine not seeing your brother for like years and years and years and years, and then like just popping up and telling him, hi, bro. Yeah, so the one and only true God, like the one and only true God, isn't happy with how you're treating his people, and you need to let them go. If it was me, I would have been so scared. Not only scared, I would have not wanted to do it. But what did Moses do? even though he was afraid, even though he was scared, he took courage and he obeyed. He obeyed. And God promised to what? Never leave him, to always be with him, and to never leave him. And then when Moses died, imagine how scared Joshua must have been. I mean, Moses was like the people's hero, like the people's hero. I think some people would have been like, Joshua, you're no Moses. You're not a leader like Moses. I think Joshua was probably scared too. But what did he do? He obeyed. There's nothing that makes you stronger or more courageous than doing something you're scared of. We can do things even when we're afraid, because who is with us and who promises to never, never leave us? Yep, you got it. God. God is with us and promises to never, never leave us. All we have to do is be strong and courageous to obey. My lovelies, what are we to obey? Hint, it's found in verse 8. Yep, you got it. We need to obey God's word. We need to obey God's commands. We must think about them day and night. But first, we need to know them, right? We need to know what to obey. And that's why we need to read God's word. We need to read God's word and think about his word and what he wants day and night, all the time. My lovelies, let's close our eyes and pray. Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for giving us your word. Thank you for giving us your word, your commands to obey. Father, we want to obey your command. We want to obey your command to love. We want to be strong and courageous in all that we do, because we believe that you are with us. We believe that you are with all of us. And Father God, right now, we take the time to especially pray for our missionary, Joseph Kim, who has dedicated his life to being with you in the mission field. We pray that the fruit of the gospel be planted in the mission field. We pray that missionary Kim help rebuild a chapel in the Necronis village. And we pray for another missionary to be sent to Edabai, a village that is close from Chase, so that your love and your kingdom be extended throughout that region. And Father God, as a new school term begins, we welcome our grade ones into service with us. We thank you for sending each and every one of them to be with us, to learn more about you, to love you more, and to learn how to and what to obey. Father God, we take this time especially to pray and to bless Ciel, Yumin, Yuna, Eden, Chua, Jun, Chunseo, Hajuni, Haeri, and Haein. We pray that your love and your light be on them always and always. Father God, we bless all our kids in Yunyeonbu. Help us have a wonderful week. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we also forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen, y'all. Okay, guys, our workbooks have arrived. So you can pick them up anytime. Well, you can ask your mom or your dad to pick them up from our church offices anytime during the week. And Teacher Jenny will also post up what to do if your parents can't really come to the office. But since you don't have them, you probably don't have them with you right now. Let's go over it together. Well, this is what it usually looks like. So we're given three questions. And the first one is today's first question. The date is the 9th of September. And the first question for today is, circle the name Moses and mark the name Joshua with a triangle every time they appear in today's passage. Now, if you have your workbooks, you'll see that it's both in Korean and English. So you can choose to do this in Korean or English, whichever you want. And I did this, and I found Moses 6 times. I found Moses twice in verse 1, once in verse 2, once in verse 3, once in verse 5, and once in verse 7. And for Joshua, I found it one time, once in verse 1. If you guys can find Moses or Joshua anywhere else, let me know, okay? If I missed anything, let me know. Question number two. Who spoke to Joshua after the death of Moses? So on the side, it says V1. And so the answer, which means the answer is found in verse 1. What does verse 1 say? What does verse 1 say? After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua of Nun, Moses' aid. So who spoke to Joshua? Who spoke to Joshua, y'all? The Lord. The Lord spoke to Joshua. Question number 3. Why was Joshua able to take the land of Canaan without fear? Why was he able to do that? The answer is in verse 5. The answer is in verse 5. So what does verse 5 say? No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. So why was Joshua able to take this land, y'all? Without fear, why was he able to take this land? Because the Lord promised to be with Joshua and never leave him. Okay, so for my grade ones that are coming up, in your workbooks, you will see, in your workbooks, after question number 3, you will usually see this sort of graph. Okay, what you need to do, let me tell you what you need to do. Look at this graph, and then in the front of your book, you will see this sort of graph. So what you do is you fill in the date and the passage, and then you either pick a whole verse or one word that you liked from reading the passage. So for Monday, if you look on the schedule, Monday is the 6th of September, right? So the 6th of September is Joshua 4, 1 to 14. And after reading Joshua 4, 1 to 14, if there's a verse that you like, you could write the whole verse down. Or if there's just a word that you like, you could just write the word down in the place that says memo. But usually, I feel like I run out of space, so I start from the place that says check. If you don't run out of space, you could just write it. You could just write your whole thing in memo. Or have a separate workbook, whatever you want. But the check usually is for your parents' signature. Your parents' signature or your grandparents' signature or like a heart. Well, I like to do hearts to just say that, yes, I've done this. So that's what you do for workbooks. I hope you understood. And everybody have a blessed, blessed week. Happy new term, y'all.